Hello, everybody. I'm Miss Iza. I would like to welcome you to our, I don't know which one, but I don't know which number, but this is the holiday play that we do every year. And our play is called A Christmas Carol, The Assistant Director's Name. Hope you enjoy.
So much to do before the premiere of the show.
I'm here.
Yeah, Frederick, you're perfect.
I know.
Good for you.
Well, thank you.
Now, don't get too smart. I'll replace you with the boombox. It'll be way cheaper.
Chill out, Ed.
Oh, where's that good-for-nothing director?
Thanks for waking me up. I was having such a horrid dream.
I'm right in front of you.
I was having such a horrid dream. Must have run out of steam after my last bender.
What bender?
Coffee bender. Found the great coffee machine in the dumpster.
Didn't you just go to the anonymous coffeeolic meeting and you're already back to your bad habits?
Right. I was supposed to tell you about that one, Eddie.
Don't you remember what happened last time?
No, what happened?
No? You don't remember being so hyper during the last production of Romeo and Juliet that you ran on stage screaming, Romeo, don't do it! Don't believe her lies! Leo, she's trying to trick you!
Oh, did I do that?
Yes!
And we casted Leonardo DiCaprio?
No, that was the maintenance guy because the original actor quit, like most of our actors in our production.
I don't recall. My therapist says to always think happy thoughts and repress the bad ones. Today is another day, and we shall put Romeo and Juliet in the ground. You get it? In the ground? Because they're dead?
I know.
You get it.
Believe you me, I'm trying my best.
Come on, it was just a little espresso. It's not like I'm on drugs. What color of the cup? Oh, what's that smell? Oh, that smell of bittersweet satisfaction. My love, come to me!
There he goes again. Didn't I say no more coffee on set? Can't you read the dang sign? As always, I have to do everything myself.
Ho ho ho, happy holidays, assistant boss.
You imbecile! The director's a caffeine addict and you brought coffee?
I'm just trying to spread Christmas spirit around. Ho ho ho.
Can't you get it through your peace sign, Brenda? No one wants to be joyful here and no one wants to hippy dippy peppermint macchiato either. At least bring some coffee-flavored coffee.
Oh, Minty Mentors, tastes just like Santa's toothpaste.
No, Jake. These are for the others.
Oh, come on, please. I just need a little more.
Don't you think we should share the joy of coffee with others?
No! I want it all!
No!
Let's not be rude. Show me. bunch of baloney. Not only we're not getting paid enough, we need to work non-stop till Christmas. When am I supposed to get my Christmas shopping done?
It's all because of Tim, by the way.
Who, me? What did I do? By the way, my name is Tom.
Tomato, tomato, why? Well, let me think. You messed up your lines 27 times at rehearsal yesterday and wasted everyone's time. We didn't even have time to rehearse our parts.
So I messed up a few times. It's not like you guys are always perfect. Has anyone else noticed that the script is almost impossible to follow? This is literally the weirdest adaptation of the Christmas Carol I've ever read.
It's not about the script, it's about acting. And we're better actors than you'll ever be.
Okay, stop arguing before the assistant director hears you.
Listen, Mirus, I don't even need this job!
What would you do if you got fired, huh?
You know I have plenty of other job opportunities.
I'm sure you do.
Why aren't you guys in your costumes yet? Get your behinds to the dressing room. Chop chop. What? I'm the one with my character, okay?
Finally!
Who are you again?
We're the ghosts.
Duh. Oh yeah, I think I love that. Here, please be very careful with this costume. It took me so much time to make.
Where are the holes for the eyes?
Wait, I'm tank.
How embarrassing!
I can't believe I spent so low. I could have been a doctor, a lawyer, an astronaut, and now I'm a dead man.
Hey, careful with that. We don't have any more money in the budget. So what could we do? What we've got? These are literally sheets with holes in them. Okay, Tennyson, get over here. It's all because of you that we're here working overtime. Thanks for that.
Why am I everyone's scapegoat? I'm not the only one who messes up. You guys are just too afraid to tell Eb because he's the assistant director. And he just changed my role last week after the first time he tripped over Eb's megaphone and broke his leg.
Doesn't that just make his character more believable?
One would think.
Jeez, that's rough. I'm not surprised though. It's not the first time I've pulled those tongues. Okay, Tom, now hold still. Let's give you a broken leg.
What in the world? Who are you? Some kind of a mafia boss?
No, silly. That's for your character.
Phew, right. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that part. Copy anyone?
Get out of here.
Yeah, no one likes you.
Oh, why? Because you're too optimistic and nobody needs to look at your happy-go-lucky face all the time.
We're just angry and have to stop picking on Tom for a bit because he got all snippy.
Okay, then I'll just leave this here for you guys. You just don't get it.
I'm ready for my makeup and costume.
Oh, yeah. Here you go.
How rude. Hello, people. I've come to save your show. I'm doing my dear friend Jake a huge favor, but no need to thank me right now. I've come to do my hair and makeup. but make it snappy. I have the shoot for the Bold and Beautiful's 100 millionth episode.
Who is that?
You don't know. But you recall she's played it the day when you're young and the rest is for like the past 20 years or something.
She sure needs to get some rest because she doesn't look too angry anymore.
Finally, we've been trying to tell Ed that he forgot to cast Mrs. Cratchit. He never listened. Ew, what is this poison?
Give me your other hand.
Get away from me, you creep!
Come back and let me finish the disinfection process.
Can you get on with it? I don't think I need that much makeup since I'm already positively radiant. And where's my costume, by the way? It better not be too cringy because this whole Miss Gachette role is already so beneath me.
Oh yeah, here you go. Straight from the Gucci Fall collection.
Oh my gosh, really? It looks fabulous. Let me try it on right now.
Are those really designer's clothes?
Yeah, totally.
Straight from the
trashments
of
Champs-Élysées. You could call it Bumshake. This is a box of duck feathers. What is it supposed to be, some kind of circus?
Well, are we doing the Mickey Mouse Christmas Carol? Because this bunch of costumes I have ordered is full of mouse ears and big yellow shoes.
Oh, for the love of Shakespeare. No, we're not. We're doing the original classic Christmas Carol. This is my chance to prove myself as a serious, dramatic actor. And you've turned me into a bird.
Well, hope no one mistakes you for Christmas dinner.
Well, I never.
We're just kidding. It's all our fault. I mess up again. We're just trying to make the best out of a bad day.
Oh, no. Speaking of a bad day.
You useless humans. Why is it taking you guys so long to get ready? Do it quickly and get on stage.
What a...
Young man, what did you just say? What do you mean, who?
Who?
You.
Cares.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I didn't mean it. Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Oh, sorry. I'm not going to get you.
I should probably get out of here before I end up like that guy.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Well, where in the world is Jake? We gotta check the lighting. Backstage? Hello? You useless three stooges.
Yeah, we're here.
It's about time.
What do we need to get done? I'm on it.
You're hopeless. You're hopeless. But since the director randomly hired you guys off the street while on one of his infamous coffee vendors, I have no choice but to work with you guys. I fire you, but it's Christmas season.
Right. And we're here.
He's on his phone. You're eating. I don't even know what she's doing. You're not here. Okay, no time to lose. Let's go. Okay, a little bit to the right. No, my right. Yes, more to the right. A little bit more. You went too far. Yup. Yup, perfect. Yeah, that's it. What a tarnation just happened. You morons just dropped a 50 kilogram light on my head. How can you be so stupid? You're all fired. Hello? Where'd you guys go? Did you guys see them? Where'd they go? You moron! You dropped a light on my head! Didn't you notice? Hello? What's up with you guys? Oh, not only are you stupid, you're deaf too?
What's with those Spice Girls?
Just about done.
Ooh, pretty.
Those are not the lights we're supposed to use! Electricity wasn't invented during the time of Christmas Carol! I can't believe who I have to work with.
I hope everyone will feel their Christmas spirit when they come tonight.
What is this moron blabbing about?
Right. Speaking of that, hey girls, have the guest list?
Yeah, somebody invited them up.
That's great. I can't wait. They will be so happy.
Me either. This will be the best holiday charity dinner yet.
Charity dinner here? No.
Where would you like the gifts?
Just set them down.
Bradford will bring and disinfect the chairs and tables as soon as Ed leaves.
Huh?
Bradford disinfects everything.
Although the boss assistant seems to have disappeared already.
Yo, I'm here!
Guess he pissed out early. It's not like he has anything to do, since we do it all for him.
And the fool should be here soon. Are you sure Abba's gone?
I'm pretty sure. I haven't seen him since the light check, and that was at noon.
I'm here, and unauthorized dinners are unacceptable! And you guys been hiding this in front of, on my back? What an outrage. Just wait till I get my megaphone. And don't you dare turn on more lights. What did I just say? Wait. You guys been hiding this from me for 5 years? Oh, you're all fired.
This looks great. Let's hang it up later. This is going to be the best one yet. We used up all of our savings to make the dinner extra special.
Yeah, doesn't it feel good to help these people?
Indeed, and better than yourself, you're present for me too. You really are, though, but...
Why, thank you. Helping others during holidays is great, and that reminds me I have more presents in my cart.
Let's help them again.
Alright, let's go.
Who do these people think they are? Using up their money for charity and presents? Oh, just wait till I get my hands on them. Oh, Father, thank you for all of the great eats to food. I mean, food to eat. Dang it, I'm never gonna get these lines right. I'm worthless. Everything that assistant director said was true. I'm useless.
Wait, Tim, sorry. Don't get down on yourself. Let's run these lines again, I'm sure you get them.
Never got these lines from the grade school. The letters just danced in front of my eyes playing hide and seek. I'm just too afraid to tell anyone, especially Ed. You'll find me on the spot.
Wait a second, are you dyslexic?
Yes, but please don't tell anyone.
Okay, your secret is safe with me. Although, don't you think everyone will be more understanding if they knew?
Sure, everyone but Ed.
So tell everyone but Ed.
Can't take the risk of someone spilling the beans. Ed will have my head if he ever found out.
I wonder why this guy is so afraid of me. I might be a little bit harsh on him, but I didn't know he's dyslexic. So technically, it's his fault for not speaking up.
I'm so embarrassed to even speak to you about this. You're a fabulous actor. I can't believe you're working in this disaster of production.
I'm not that great. If we're already telling secrets, I'll have to confess as well. I never went to that fancy acting school in New York.
What?
I didn't get in. I lied on my resume. I've never even taken a drama class with Miss Iza before. I taught myself how to act. I'm a phony.
You sure are!
Wait, he taught himself? Miss Iza would be proud.
Wow, really? Well, you're the best actor I know so far, so does it really matter you've gone to the school?
Well, unfortunately it does, if you want to make it big. I want to use this play as a stepping stone. Maybe someone important will see me and take me to Broadway. I hope my secret will be safe with you. It would be an absolute tragedy if I be found out.
It sure would. You could start rehearsing your dramatic death scene. Because you're D.E.D. You hear me? Dead! Yes, I completely understand. I know Abby won't. But let's keep running my lines. I don't want to ruin your big break.
Oh, I understand something very well. I understand I'm working with a bunch of liars!
Constantly making mistakes.
He only notices other people's mistakes. He doesn't see the big picture. He probably didn't notice that he ordered a bunch of questions for Mickey Mouse Christmas Carol. And I've been trying to remake all of them for the past month.
Oh, did I really do that? And Fran's working unpaid overtime to fix my mistake? Well, she should have told me. My mind has been filled with that good-for-nothing director and his mind in clouds of coffee.
I tried to tell him, but he didn't listen, as usual. So I had to take the reins myself. Worst part is that no one even will acknowledge all of my hard work.
I don't remember anything about that. What's her name? Tell me anything about costumes. What is her name again?
Anyway, what are you doing here, Jenny?
Well, I was looking for Jake.
Why?
I heard a scream that sounded like him, but he's nowhere to be found.
That's not good. I didn't hear anything. I guess the caution crate. I hope you find Jake. Hope he's okay.
Okay, great. Thanks. Jake?
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 Why are they looking for Jake? That dimwit director? He's probably just fallen asleep in a pile of costumes again.
Ah!
Who's doing that? How long is this over, you nincompoop? Stop trying to freak me out.
Ah!
Now this is starting to get creepy. I bet the 10th graders are behind this. Damn it. I had enough of your prank. Come out so I can yell at you properly.
Thank you.
At least I know how to stop this madness. Jake!
Ah, please! Help! Anyone but the final boss! Can't deal with the Nightmare of My Nightmares again!
What's going on, Jake? I'm not here to hurt you. I'm just trying to help. Wake up!
I am onto you. I will never succumb to your evil schemes!
Ah! The Eggenator! Run!
What is it, Charles Dickens, just happened? No one could hear me or see me. Am I D.E.D.? But moreover, why did Jake run away from me? I'm just an innocent assistant director. He's the one that constantly makes mistakes and goes on coffee vendors. But I know why he wouldn't want to fall asleep. He should really get another shrink.
You are on the bus now, referring Torin to Karen Dixon's new Discord!
Oh! Real moment, the fog.
I'm so glad that I'm in this warm shelter, yet very smelly. Someone really needs to get this to the laundromat.
Did you hear that just now?
Yeah, it sounded like Ev coming from the pile of costumes.
So I'm not crazy.
Nah, we both must be, but speaking of Ev, I need to make an announcement.
What a relief, they can hear me.
Hey guys, could you gather around here for a second? I've got something to say. Merry Christmas, everyone. You all know how hard you've been working on this play, right?
Yeah.
Right, so that's why I would like to gather some money to get our higher-ups a Christmas present.
What? Are you kidding, kid? For Jake? Sure, but why would we give Evan presents? A whole people. He's been nothing but mean to us the entire time.
And he's so unreasonable.
And stingy.
And ungrateful.
And scary.
All he's ever done was mess up and blame it on us.
The dude's got no soul. And he never disinfects his hands.
What's wrong with my hands?
He doesn't appreciate us. Why wouldn't we appreciate him?
Well, because it's Christmas, and we should always try to see the good in people.
That's true, Bob. Plenty of their ashes any good to see.
Yeah, unfortunately, when it comes to F, he should get what he deserves. And I think we all agree that he should get nothing.
Yeah, nothing. Sorry, Bob. Sorry.
Sorry.
You know how it is.
I'll show the foosball. Calling all cast and crew, get on stage immediately. Move it. Hello everyone, I hope you know why I've called you here.
No.
I want you all to go home.
What?
Are you firing us?
You must have heard something smack about him.
I want you to go home and spend the holidays with your family, or whatever floats your boat.
So you're not firing us?
Why would I? You guys have been working your tails off to make this production a success. I feel like everyone deserves a break.
But why the change of heart?
Let's just say I had a Christmas revelation.
Well, let's not just stand here with our jaws dropped and get out of here before he changes his mind.
I won't, don't worry. Actually, wait.
Oh, no.
I'd also like to show my appreciation to each and every one of you by giving you all raises and bonuses.
Yes!
So get out of here and enjoy your holidays.
Woohoo!
Let's go!
Yay!
Well,
money.
Thank you, sir. I knew you were a great guy.
Don't mention it, Paul. Nah, I was a villain. But from now on, I'll try my best to be the protagonist.
Okay. That's wonderful, sir. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you too, Bob. Now, if you excuse me, I gotta go find Jake.
Alright, sir.
Jake! Oh, Jake!
Oh my god, thanks for waking me up. I was having such a horrid dream. There were like ghouls and like spiders and other scary characters.
Jake, we gotta talk.
Are you gonna yell at me? Wait, please don't yell at me. I don't want to drink coffee anymore.
No, I'm not gonna yell anymore. We need to get you some proper help for your night terrors, so you'll be healthy, rested, and happy, so you can save this play.
Who, me?
Well, you are the director, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Raving about Charles Dickens' Christmas Carol, which premiered this week at the Uptown Theater. Director Jacob Marlowe is a genius of our time. His adaptation of the classic tale has touched our hearts.
Nice. Oh, the up-and-coming star of the show, Otis Willis, has an extraordinary talent.
Yes.
He's bound to get snatched up by the Broadway.
Ooh, nice.
Nice. Bethany Bacall is radiant as Mrs. Cratchit and younger than ever, obvi.
As Tiny Tim and Bob Pullman couldn't have been a better Mr. Cratchit.
The Christmas ghosts, past, present, and future, were mesmerizing.
The special effects and lighting on the spot and creative contemporary costume and makeup styling added to the theme.
And the music accompanying couldn't have it more perfect. And the literary play of Frederick Chopinowski in this one note in the 46th form of the Polonaise. Should have been an earth shot. What the?
What is this? What kind of ears does this guy have? That's impossible to catch.
And no one's perfect.
Go see this hit before it's sold out. The Uptown Theater would like to also invite you for a new charity benefit, funded by Assistant Director Ebony Scott.
Nice.
Money will be raised to help fund research for victims of PTSD.
Well, looks like we're gonna pull it off. Congrats!
And we couldn't have done it without Eb.
Who? Yeah. Me?
Yeah, you had a textbook character development arc.
Yeah, you really changed for the better.
And positively influenced all the cast and crew.
Yeah, it's so much better to work with all of you than working with the crew of Young and Restless.
Thanks a lot, guys. It means a lot. But I wouldn't have been able to do it without you guys, and especially my old buddy Jake.
Yeah.
Oh,
gee, thanks, Eb. You saved my life. Ever since you got me that PTSD specialist, I started yoga. Now I'm as calm as a cucumber. I sleep like a baby, and I'm more flexible. Look at this.
Whoa. That's great to hear. Let's go out and celebrate our great success. There's a new vegan place down the street. On me.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm gonna have chocolate.
Lychee green tea latte for everyone.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you think there's gonna be tea flavored tea?
Well, that's a good question, but you know, the 90s are indie too. Maybe they'll have a fancy crafty flavor
Oh!
Thank you to Mr. Meddy and to Victoria. Victoria, our stage manager and sound and lighting, and Mr. Hogan that's over there. He was the drummer.
Thank you.